This is a flying video. Saturday, August 15, 2020. Vancouver, Washington. The hottest day on the hottest weekend of the year.
Bloody hell, I'm sweating here. Roasting, boiling, baking, sweltering. It's like a sauna, furnace.
The temperature up north looks much, much better. Shouldn't we spend the weekend at Friday Harbor?
Yes, 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 yes!
That settles that. Friday Harbor it is. Friday Harbor's on the east edge of San Juan Island. It's a great little town. Most important, it's an island surrounded by cold ocean and a great destination to get to by airplane. This is a 1979 Grumman Tiger, and this is my co-pilot, Max. We'll be flying north from Vancouver, Washington, over Hood Canal, and across the Strait of Juan de Fuca to San Juan Island. One of the great things about this airplane is how easy it is to load bikes and other gear. Plenty of room for our little vacation. Once we're loaded up, it's time to fuel up and get out of town.
Is clear. All right, here we go.
Party time.
After departing Pearson Airfield, we stay below Portland's airspace as we fly over Vancouver, Washington.
Fort Lima's red of contact, a mile and a half to the northeast of the island in Vancouver Lake.
Then, we pick up flight following from ATC and climb to our cruising altitude.
Fort Lima for flight following, contact point approach 124.35.
Fortuna, Fort Lima, to your discretion, maintain your flight.
Now we're gonna climb up to 8,500.
All right, it feels good to actually be cold.
That's pretty good, 88 degrees up here.
There is 100 degrees on the ground.
At this point, Max and I figured out that we hadn't turned on the cockpit camera.
Woo-hoo! Up ahead, you see that body of water?
Which one?
Right up in front of us.
About 12 o'clock, yeah, I see it.
You know what that is?
Yeah.
That's a Puget
Sound. Puget Sound?
Yeah.
Grumman 4542 Lima, contact approach 120.4 today.
120.4. Here's a nice shot of Olympia, Washington as we fly over Bud Inlet in South Puget Sound.
Simple as a flower, and that's a complicated thing.
Now that we're over the Puget Sound, it's only 65 degrees up here, so it cooled down about 20 degrees once we got over this ocean.
Hell yeah.
We're not going to try and fly too close to Seattle today because the visibility's shit.
Yeah, also, what's that big cloud of stuff?
It's called an inversion.
How much longer?
28 minutes.
Oh, sweet.
Now, the question is, if we had the land, do you think we could make that runway right there?
Yes, thank you.
Two.
And if not, there's a sweet little grassy spot right over there that we could just bop down. I mean, yeah. It's like a giant little gouge in the yep. hills, it gives perfect runway. Just yep. boom.
Notice this town, what's closer to us? That's Bremerton. That's the Bremerton shipyard. That's where the naval base is. They've got aircraft carriers. And over here, that area is where that's the submarine base, the nuclear sub base.
That sounds scary and very important.
God, that is just beautiful.
Above the mountains.
With reverse, Grumman 4542 Lima, 8600 VFR.
Grumman 4542 Lima, would be approach of the altimeter 2900,
8900. 2989, approach to Lima.
I see the runway. It's about 20 miles in front of us.
Me too.
So do you see this big long spit that goes like this? Cool. All right, so let's do a pre-landing checklist.
Want me to read it while you keep your hands on the wheel?
Yeah, so I want to approach and land. Well, we're going to start descending now at about 500 feet per minute.
I expect there's going to be some bumps?
No.
Oh, cool.
If there are, they'll be real light.
Gotcha.
Number 14, the radar service is terminated. Squawk VFR frequency change group.
Rocket VFR, frequency change approved. Thanks for the help. Roger, Lima.
Squawk VFR, frequency change approved.
Roger, Lima.
Jazz person.
We taxied to a transient parking space and then unloaded the bikes and gear.
Well, we made it. We're at Friday Harbor. There's Max hiding in the shade back there. It took us about an hour and 20 minutes to get here. We're gonna get the bags out of here, tie the plane down, and then go check into the hotel and then go see what's up.
So, what are we doing?
We're on our way for a glorious bike ride. Max, what's the temperature supposed to be like today?
Look at the guy hanging.
70s? 75 today.
On our way to the south end of the island, we passed by the airfield. scenery was great, and we were in high spirits. The ride back to town was pleasant, too.
Hey there. We did. It's beautiful. South Beach is beautiful.
We spent the rest of the day in town near the harbor. The next morning, it was time to prepare to head home.
So, we're pre-flighting to go home. We're getting the plane geared up and stuff. Bikes are in here. Oh yeah, and you can stand on the wing too. You just gotta be careful. You just like that. Alright, that was just Dad checking the stall horn.
Before heading south, we'll make a brief 20-minute detour, going just north of Bellingham. My dad lives in the area, and even though COVID makes things more difficult, we're gonna have a socially distanced get-together. He's a badass. He flew for the Air Force in the Vietnam era, and later, he was a bush pilot in Southeast Alaska. It's a real treat to fly over and see him. We made the short hop to the neighborhood airstrip in Linden, and then biked the short distance to the city park for lunch. Then it was time to head home. First, an overflight over Bellingham Airport. Then we head south, picking our way through the Puget Sound and below Seattle's Class Bravo airspace. The visibility was a little better, giving us a good view of the city. Back in Vancouver, touchdown at Pearson Airfield.
I'm sitting in the railway station, got a ticket for my destination. On a tour of one-night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet.